Unicellular organism like, okay, yeast. Yeast is that unicellular fungi. It is that important bit. Unicellular fungi is the yeast. And hydra. So it is that nidaria, okay, or porifera, okay, phylum. So both hydra and yeast. So this both are showing that budding process. It is the objective bit. Okay, unicellular organism like yeast. Okay, it means like yeast, unicellular fungi and hydra showing of that asexual reproduction takes place by that budding process. Right? So after that, some living organisms are not able to reproduce. Okay? Some living organism are not able to reproduce. Able to reproduce. So what are the sterile worker bees? Sterile worker honey bees. Okay. Second one, mules. And unfertile human couple or infertile human couple. Human couple. So these three living organisms are not able to reproduce. What are that? Sterile worker honeybees, mules, and also unfertile human couple. So that's why reproduction is not a, okay, defining living character, because so some living organism are not able to reproduce. That's why so it, reproduction is not a, okay, so living character. It is not defining living character. What is the objective? For example, all living organisms, reproduction is not a, okay, living character, defining reproduction is not a defining a living character. How can you explain that? It means sterile worker bees, mules, and infertile human couple are not able to reproduce. That's why reproduction is not a living character, right? After that reproduction, metabolism, right? It is another living character. Another living character is the metabolism. What is the meaning? For example, all living organisms are made up of, okay, all living organisms are made up of, all living organisms are, okay, so made up of different chemicals and growth. Both are synonymous characters. Both are synonyms. Synonyms. Okay? In unicellular organism, the objective it. In unicellular organism. In unicellular organism. Right? So reproduction, growth, both are synonymous in unicellular organism. We cannot differentiate it. Which one is growth? Which one is that reproduction? Okay? So reproduction, it means takes place by the cell division. Next, growth, before the cell division. So unicellular organisms can, it means increase in size. That is known as the growth. So that's why we cannot differentiate it, that growth and reproduction in unicellular organism. So both are synonyms. So it is at a objective bit. Okay? Right. After that, now start metabolism. Metabolism. Metabolism is another living character. Another Another living character is known as that metabolism. Right? So, it means all living organisms are made up of different chemicals. Sizes and belongs to that different categories and different classes. Right? All living organisms are made up of different chemical sizes, categories and classes. Right? So, in metabolism process, it means these chemicals are formed from other chemicals. These chemicals are formed from other chemicals and these chemicals are converted into the another chemicals. These chemicals convert to that other chemicals. Other chemicals. So they are known as the conversions. These chemical conversions takes place in that body of living organism. So that is known as that these metabolic reactions, they are known as that metabolic reactions. These chemical reactions, these chemical conversions are known as chemical reactions. So, thousands of chemical reactions takes place in that, in all body of living organism, they are known as that metabolic reaction. This sum total of metabolic reactions takes place in body of living organism that is known as metabolism. So it means some total of metabolic reactions takes place in body of living organism, that is known as that metabolism process. So it means metabolism is required. So in all, it means body of living organisms. For example, you take that one living reaction, one isolated living reaction. Isolated means separated. Isolated living reaction occur in vitro means outside of the body in non-living object, that is known as the test tube. It means isolated reaction occur in vitro outside of the body in non-living object. In this non-living object, it is a non-living thing. Generally, this object is a non-living thing. But reaction is that living reaction. It means, so all metabolic reactions are, living characters. It means metabolism is a defining property of living organism. So metabolism is required for higher level of organism for cellular organization. Metabolism required. To higher organism for cellular organization. for cellular organization, right? So that is known as that metabolism. So it means all the characters are so involved in that all living organism showing of that metabolic reactions. After that metabolism, so what is that irritability? Irritability. Okay. Irritability means what is the meaning? So it is the ability to sense environment. Ability to sense environment shows suitable response. It means it shows suitable response. Suitable response. Okay. So it is that mostly obvious and technically complicated, mostly obvious and technically complicated living character. Living character. Right? So it is that objective. Which one is mostly obvious and technically so complicated? Living character means irritability or ability to sense environment showing suitable response. Okay. Living organisms can respond to that environment stimulus. All living organisms can respond to environment stimuli. So this stimuli is either it is that physical, chemical or biological. Physical, chemical or biological. So for example, human beings sense to the environment their sense organs. Human beings sense to that environment by sense organs. Next, plants, animals, it means respond to that environmental factors. So what are that environmental factors? So for example, plants, animals respond to the environmental factors. So these environmental factors are, light, temperature, chemicals, pollutants and other organisms. Okay. So for example in plants and animals, photoperiod effect, reproduction. So it means reproduction is also mainly depend upon that photoperiod affects reproduction in seasonal breeders like in plants and animals. Okay. So it means photoperiod means duration of day and okay. So night time affect that reproduction in seasonal breeders. It means some plants producing flowers and fruits only at seasons only. And animals also can reproduce depend upon the season. So animals can reproduce mostly in some certain season. So it is mainly depend upon that photoperiod. Okay. Then photoperiod affects reproduction process, right? In seasonal breeders, in plants and animals, right? After that, all living organisms are aware of surroundings. So that is known as consciousness. Consciousness means what is the meaning? all living organisms. All living organisms having awareness to the surroundings. Awareness to surroundings. Right? So all living organisms having awareness to surroundings, that is known as that consciousness. But only human being having that self-consciousness, it is an objective bit. It means human beings aware himself. Only human being having that aware himself, that is known as that self-consciousness process, right? So that is that consciousness. After that, so living state, we cannot define that living state. It is a difficult. Which one is difficult to define that character, that is known as a living state. Living state we cannot define easily. It is difficult. For example, on patients lying in hospitals, on patients lying in coma in hospitals, so in this brain is dead, next other organisms cannot perform that work, but these organs are virtually supported by that it means some non-living objects. It means at the time brain is dead, but these organisms are virtually supported by that machines. So that's why it means the patient is present in coma, but these organisms are can perform work by the machines in hospitals. That's why brain is dead, but he is present at a living condition. That's why living state we cannot easily define. It is very difficult, right? After that, interaction process. Interaction process means what is the meaning? All living organism underlying interaction. All living organisms. All living organisms underlying interaction. For example, you take that properties of tissues. One example, properties of tissues are not present in cell constituents. Properties of tissues are not present in cell constituents, but it is arise as a result of interaction. Same as that, properties of cell organella. Properties of cell organella are not present in molecular constituents. So properties of tissues are not present in cell constituents, arise as a result of interaction. It means we cannot identify that properties of tissues in cell constituents. When the all cell constituents are it means combined or interacted, so that is known as that tissue. Same as that, properties of cell organelle are not present in molecular constants. As a result, it is that interaction of that molecular constants. It means properties of cell organelle are not individually present in molecular present. It is a combinedly group of interaction of that molecular constants. So that is known as a interaction. That's why interaction is required for all living organisms. Okay, so for all organisms, which one is required? Interaction. Without interaction, so we cannot define that living character. Okay, so in higher level of organism, so interaction is necessary for a complex body of organization at hierarchical level. It means higher hierarchy level, which one is the necessary? So interaction is the necessary. That's why it means living organisms are, what are that characters of definition of that living character? What is living? Living means the organisms ability to self-replicate, self-organize, self-regulate, interactive system, interactive system, and shows suitable response to environment stimuli or stimulus. So that is known as the living organism. That is the living means the organisms having ability, the organism having ability to self-replicate, self-organize, self-regulate, interactive system, and shows suitable response to that environmental stimulus. That is known as that living, right? After that, all living organisms are linked one to each other, present, past, and future, by the sharing of common genetic material, but with different degrees. It means different values. It means all living organisms are linked one to each other. It means present, past, and future. Okay, so living organisms are linked. How it is? By sharing common genetic material. That is known as the DNA, common genetic material. With different values. So that is known as the living character. In this, growth, reproduction, metabolism, ability to sense environment, irritability, and interaction. In this, what are the main living character? So what are the main living character? So first one is the metabolism. It is a defining property. Second one is ability to sense environment. It is known as irritability. After that, interaction. These are the living characters. Okay, growth, reproduction are not living characters. They are not defining living characters, right? So after that, diversity in living world. Diversity in living world. So it means when you go to that different areas, then we observe that different species of plants, animals, and other organism. For example, so we go to that forest, then the observations are, when that species are increases, then observations are also increases. It means each different kind of plant and animal species is known as the biodiversity. Each different kind of plant species or animal species or organisms. Each different kind of plant species, animal species or organisms is known as that diversity. Different kinds of, so for example on the earth 1.7 to 1.8 million species are present. Million species are present. So that is known as that biodiversity. That is known as a biodiversity, right? So it is also objective. How much? Okay, what is the meaning of biodiversity? 1.7 to 1.8 okay, million species are present on the earth. So that is known as that biodiversity.